are back with another Quad City business. Hey, how about that? Prescott Station Grill and Bar. We have the owner, Robert Gabrick, with us. Hi, Robert. Great to have
you
back.
See you again.
Happy New Year again. All my guests, I get to say Happy New Year too. Mm-hmm. The first time I see you
New
this
year.
So, Quad City Business News, you have something special from them.
Well, it's a great segue because they do an annual survey, and it's one vote, one voter. And for the fourth year in a row, we have won best restaurant fine dining category in the Quad Cities area.
Phenomenal. It doesn't surprise me. Best food, delicious. It's so creative and wonderful. Now, things have changed. You know, winter's hit us. It's cold. We haven't seen any moisture. But nevertheless, that changes the restaurant business. We want to have different kind of food and stuff. So what's happening at Prescott Station?
A lot is happening. First of all, I wanted to thank you, Quad City, and maybe to a little degree my chefs and front of the house people for giving us the best month of December that we've ever had.
Congratulations.
In 5.5 years. And so thank you all for that.
And I have to say, I love that because not only is the food unusual and delicious, I always am in for a treat when I go there, but your wait staff is, they are far just so friendly. I feel like I've known them. In fact, I get embarrassed like, oh, am I supposed to know who they are because they're so wonderful to work with. So that's great. But the food, again, the food is phenomenal. You've brought a whole selection of things. Do you have a new winter menu, or what's happening?
Well, we are going to be doing a few things differently, and you know, I have come in and talked about seafood with you before, and talked about meats. Some of the changes, people keep recommending us as Prescott Steakhouse, so we are embracing it. We have such great meats, and so we decided that we were going to enhance our menu, and so we have been blessed with finding a source for prime grade American Wagyu cap steaks. And almost no one in the state of Arizona does cap steaks, but
it's a little more rare than that.
We're a little ridiculous.
No pun intended.
Right, exactly. And so you can see the marbling on that is just phenomenal. We have elk ribs. That is our prime rib roast that we cut ribeyes from. Prime grade New York steaks.
It all looks just so, it does look rich and tender and meaty. I mean, that really looks amazing.
We are blessed with finding some great sources for product.
Great.
And then over the New Year's weekend, we offered ribeye from Buffalo, and that was a huge success. Goodness. People loved it, and so that will make its way
very
to our
unusual
menu.
Well, this looks good. You treat it different. You have ways of really marinating and treating your meats, depending on what they are.
Well, we have a specialty rub that just pops the flavors and makes it so if you want a steak that is that good, you have to come see us.
That's right, because you got the secrets. Well, in seafood, we've talked about seafood before, and you have like this exclusive fresh seafood partnership.
It shows that if you're willing to put out the effort, you can get rewarded by it. And so we get shellfish from the Pacific Northwest and Canada. We have our fish flown in from Alaska and Hawaii. And so if you work at it in this day and age, it's one of the beautiful things of today is that you can get the product that you dream of in. It may cost a little bit more, but that's the bar we wanted to set. And because of awards like that, it shows that some of our customers are appreciating it, and we appreciate them.
Well, because seafood is something that's so important to have it right fresh from the water. Because,
right.
I mean, if it gets frozen or if it's like a few days old, I mean, it makes such a big difference. So if you've got fresh seafood in Arizona, you're going to be a hit. And you are, Robert. That's the thing. Prescott Station, you know, gets that within, you know, hours. And it's
and every time
delicious.
We get a compliment, we redouble our efforts because the last thing we ever want to do is disappoint someone.
Right. Well, I don't think you are. Now, were you saying that you're open 7 days a week now? Did I hear that?
Or? We're changing a little bit.
Okay.
Part of it has to do with the fact that Linda and I, by the time we get to January 1st, we're pretty exhausted, and our poor kitchen staff, and you know Will and Stanley, and they're fabulous people, but a lot of people don't understand is that there's double duty for kitchen. There's the plating up of entrees that you feed people, but then after all that product has been served, you have to make new to get ready for the next day. And so part of what we've done is that we're closing for lunch Monday through Friday. We did that last year too.
Okay.
And so our hours now become 7 nights a week. We open at 3. Our bar opens at 3 with happy hour every single day from 3 to 6, and our dinner menu starts at 3. We'll have a sunset dinner as of Monday that will feature some items at $15 from 3 to 4:30, and then we'll have weekend brunch. So our very popular Sunday brunch becomes right. Saturday and Sunday brunch.
Oh, both days. Boy,
both
that's going to help people out a lot.
We hope so.
So just changing things up. And your menu now, is your dinner menu a little different now with the new year? Or is it pretty much you're bringing the favorites back and just keeping those? Or
It condenses a little bit because of the fact that we see less people. And so when you have really fresh product, you need people to be able to move it through. And sure. So we use our intelligence and the fact that we keep records of what we sell to be able to narrow the menu a little bit so that the most popular items are there. We'll do some wintertime things like paellas and stuff like that that will make it to our menu. And like I said, buffalo ribeye and items like that are going to make it to the menu.
Like really special things.
Right.
And you guys, you know, you do specialize in this fresh stuff, but then also, as I said, it's so unique. And you, your chefs create a lot of the dishes that you serve. I mean, they tweak this up and they make it their own because it's just not anything I've had any other place, and it's so good, Robert. I have to keep saying that.
Well, one of the things that would scare me most is if somebody ever walked into my restaurant and said, "My menu looks familiar," because that would scare me. So one of the reasons I think that we have so much of our kitchen staff that have been with us for over 5 years is the fact that we give them a creative outlet. And so the mind meld that we have between myself and them really works well. And so the door is open for all imagination and all ideas.
Great atmosphere, everything. Where are you located?
We are located across from the Haciampa, 200 East Gurley. At Marina and Gurley Street.
Yeah, right. Very accessible, good parking, a wonderful, close to downtown, everything, Prescott Station Grill and Bar, and the bar part is important too, because I know the drinks are a big part too. But anyway, thank you so much, Robert Gabrick, and Happy
Pleasure.
New Year.
Happy New Year.
A good year, we can tell, over at Prescott Station Grill and Bar, because we're going to be over there eating all of this delicious stuff. Thanks for joining us, Robert.
You're welcome.
Wow. All right. Don't go away. We're going to take a break. We will be right back.